Hello, this is Brian. Today we're doing the flame test for metals lab in Beyond Labs. I'm going to click my open button here for the virtual chem lab. Here we go. And let's see, descriptive chemistry. And we're going to click on flame test for metals. So on the right side of our virtual stockroom here, we have a label unknowns. I'm going to click on that. And that opens up, activates these bottles so they're ready to be used. And I'm going to create a test tube with an unknown in it, a practice unknown. So I'm going to click on the chemicals we need. Let's see, where are they? So there's sodium. What else does it say to click on? Potassium, calcium, barium, strontium, and copper. Now over here, do not change the minimum or maximum figures. Just click this little button up here, create unknown. And look right there, we've got an unknown. When I mouse over it, you can see over here on this window, it tells you, it says practice unknown. I'm going to drag that thing over to our test tube rack. Now, as it says on step three of the Beyond Labs sheet, I'm going to grab a test tube from our test tube box, click and drag over to our metal test tube stand. When you put something in there in the metal test tube stand, that's when it activates all the bottles over here so we can put stuff in it. And all I have to do, what does it say, to click on the sodium bottle. And check it out, it just immediately fills this test tube up in our stand with sodium. You can see in the zoom blow up window here, it's got sodium in there. And now I'm just going to drag this over and put it in our test tube rack. And it says to repeat that procedure. So with the other test tube, with the other chemicals, that is, I'm gonna drag another test tube, put it over here. What's next? Potassium. Click on potassium. You can see it says potassium right there. The window. Drag this over here. Notice when you mouse over it, the first one I put in there says sodium over here in the blow-up window still. This one says potassium. The original thing we put there says the unknown. I'm going to finish our procedure up here. What's next? Calcium. And now we see we have calcium in there. Barium. We have barium in there. Strontium again. Copper. Oh, well, that one's blue, as copper solutions tend to be. So again, now that we have our lineup of test tubes, you can scroll mouse over each and it shows you in the zoom in window what's in that test tube. It's kind of a handy thing. Now on step five of your sheet, it says to grab the sodium. I'm mousing over, I can see that's my sodium test tube. I'm gonna put it on the test tube stand. All the actions we do in the virtual chem lab happen to the test tube in the test tube stand over here. You can't do anything to these test tubes over here. You have to put it here to do something. And it says to click the flame button. So here's our flame, our Bunsen burner. I'm going to click that and look up here, see what happens. Wait for a few seconds and we can see, and we have an observation we can make here. Good look at that flame, record your data, especially paying attention to the color. Now let's do that again. Now I guess it's already giving us a frozen image of it. This, what that's simulating is as if in the physical chemistry lab, as if we took a, say, a piece of metal wire and we put some of the, this sodium solution on there and physically burned it over the Bunsen burner. That's the kind of thing we would see. And let's do the same with the cobalt glass in front. That's the cobalt glass right there in front of the flame. And record your observations. There's a lot less going on here. You can barely see it. Now we're done with the sodium, so we can put the sodium back and grab the potassium, put that in. That's our next one. The other way we can do it, they have a shortcut here in the lab. I can grab, say, let's say grab the sodium and just put it there, and it immediately puts the sodium in and the potassium back. It switches places. I don't like doing it that way as much, but I'll do that again here. So now we have our potassium in there and our sodium has magically appeared back in our rack. And we're ready to do the flame test on the sodium. So let's click the flame and record your observation, especially the color right there. After a little bit, it stops burning. Now we'll do it with a cobalt glass plate in front of the flame and record what you see there. Oh, now you can see it well. Okay. Put that one back. I'm going to repeat the procedure with the other test tubes. So we have the calcium filled test tube. Let's click on the flame, see what we have here. Wait a few seconds. There we go. We've got a color. Okay. So for the rest of them, it says not to use the cobalt glass plate in front of the flame. Just use the regular Bunsen burner flame. So that's the calcium. Let's try the barium. Well, that one definitely looks different. Okay. Strontium. Finally, the copper. Oh yeah, that one definitely looks different too. Now you should be, your data table should be mostly filled out by now with the color of the flame of each of those. You can always repeat, just click and drag any test tube back there and repeat any test you want to get your data table filled out. And we're now ready to perform a flame test on the practice unknown. That's step 8 of the Beyond Labs. I'm dragging the unknown test tube now over there, and we're going to try to figure out what's in there. Let's click the flame, take a look there. Okay. So what you want to do is figure out the color, look on your data table of all the colors you came up with, and see which one that most closely resembles. We could do it with the cobalt glass plate too, see if that comes up with anything. Okay, so that's your task, to figure out which one of these that one is. You can repeat, like I said, you can repeat any of these to compare until you feel confident that you know what this one is. Now I'm going over to the lab book here. I'm clicking on that and that opens that up. And we click the report button down here. You can read that first. This is where we make our educated guess as to which of those 6 ions was in that unknown test tube. Let's say I think it was, I'm going to click on the potassium. That's what I think it was. I have no idea if that's right, but let's click submit and see what happens. Oh, Okay, so it looks like I got it wrong. The red ones show what is wrong. It means I did not get the right one. That's interesting. I think what this means, the dark red is the wrong guess that I made, potassium. I think the lighter red or pink, whatever that is, I think that one shows what the real answer was. Okay, I'm just clicking back on the stock room to go to the next part. I think I found a mistake in our instructions on the worksheet there. It says to click on the red disposal bucket, but do not do that. That will ruin everything here. Instead, what we want to do is take the test tube, the unknown you just guessed on, and drag that over to the bucket. And what it does is it automatically generates a new practice unknown for you. So we can grab that and drag that over there. So the goal here is to do four different practice unknowns. So we've got the new one up. Let's burn it under the flame, see what color it is. Okay. I've made my guess, so I'm going to open the lab book, click report. I think that one was copper. Click that, submit, and look, I got it right. All of them are green. That shows that I got it right. The dark green is the one I guessed. Click out. Throw that one away. Generates a new unknown again for us. Now we can do the third one. Click the flame. Okay. Going to try the cobalt glass plate over the flame. See what we get. Okay, I've made my guess. I'm going with potassium this time. Let's see what happens. Oh, look, I got it right. Woohoo! I think that's three. So this should be the fourth one. See what we have here. Let's try the cobalt. I'm not sure on this one. I'll make my guess anyway. I'm going with calcium. Let's see what happens. Oh, nope, that was wrong. Looks like it was potassium again. So don't forget to write in your data sheet your four guesses for the four practice unknowns, and you have a couple questions at the end of your Beyond Labs sheet to answer. And that's it for today.